And today I am going to talk about the most memorable moment in my life. The most memorable moment in my life was when my sister was born. In the hospital, I can never forget the first time I carried her on my lap. Today, my sister sometimes doesn't understand me, but that day, if she had seen that day, if she could understand me that day, she would know how happy I felt that day. It was a very funny incident that happened that day. After the first time I held my sister on my lap, I was leaning on the bed railing, and then suddenly they gave away and I fell down. I was laughing that time because nothing could take away all that happiness. So that is the most memorable moment.
Okay, thank you.
That I can never forget.
Yeah, you can just clap like this. Now, how are you going to clap? Are you going to clap like this or how? Audience. Yeah. Ananya, clap. Okay, next. Who's next?
Mommy.
Yes, Anish, go ahead.
Ma'am, is this fine?
What is fine? Oh, are you standing?
Ma'am, the camera.
That's okay.
Let's be grateful to the people who make us happy. They are my parents. A very good afternoon to everyone. My name is Anish, and today I would like to share. Sorry, ma'am.
That's okay.
And I would like to share one incident where I was very happy. I remember those moments when it was my 10th birthday and my parents gave me a surprise gift. The gift that was very, very memorable. It was my first. It was my first laptop. I always cherish that moment.
Wow.
I always cherish that moment, and I feel so lucky to have such loving parents. Thank you all.
Audience, polling. Okay, thank you, Anish. Try to avoid repetition. Like, I always cherish the moment. It's like my heart thing. Okay, next. Yes.
Ma'am, next.
Who's it, Vaishnavi or Mota clicking? Who's it? Vaishnavi? Yeah, Nisha. Who's it? Vaishnavi,
me.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead. I know Amit Pradeep will come late. He's preparing a lot, you know. Pradeep. Yeah. Yes, Vaishnavi. I can't hear you. Can't hear you. We are in mute, yeah. Yes, I can. Now. I can't hear you. Okay, remove the earpiece. Speak now. Okay. No. I'm so sorry. Check with call mom or dad. Call mommy, daddy. Yeah. Okay, anyone else? Ananya Spanish, Anisha Spanish, who's next? Yes, Trivali, please go ahead. I will unmute you. Yeah. Yes.
I want to say one of my best memorable moments, and it is in Darjeeling when I experienced rock climbing. And we will ride in the air, down the water will be, and our family went to Darjeeling, and first I participated in that.
Okay, crazy for faster. Okay, fine. Thank you, Shivali. Audience.
Thank you.
You're supposed to, yeah. See, only they didn't know they come. Have you finished or not? They're still, they're waiting for the information. Okay, who's next?
Me.
Anish finish. Yes. Yes. Yeah.
May I start?
Yes.
My memorable moment was we went to Dubai for the vacation last year. So our visa was about to finish. So we were not expecting anything. We were just expecting to pack our stuff. Then suddenly my father told that my father's friend is going to take us. My father told his friend to bring his car, and we will be going to Ferrari World. I was so happy that time. While we were going to Ferrari World, me and my sister was singing on the way. We are like so happy that time.
Okay.
And that is the first time I went to the roller coaster. There was a very fast roller coaster, but I was not the age to go there. There was another fast one, which my tongue was sticking out, and my mother was crying. My sister was closing her eyes. And at last, when we were going back, we bought ice cream. We finished it very fast. We were living in Dubai and was in Abu Dhabi. We went at 8 o'clock from Ferrari World, and we reached at like 12 o'clock. I'm not sure.
Mom, I live in Abu Dhabi. Mom, the roller coaster he wanted to go is called Formula Rosa. It's the fastest roller coaster in the world.
I'm so sick. I'm very scared of all the rides. As the last one, the way your mom cried, I would have run away from the place. I would have
run away. He should go to Bollywood Parks in Dubai.
Okay, next time we target that, okay?
Mom,
can you hear me?
So
funny.
Okay. Yeah, it's so funny. Yeah, very much. He's mom, still enjoying the moment. He's still enjoying the moment, you know. He's saying mom was crying, my sister. Okay, thank you.
My mom didn't even step into Ferrari World that time when she saw the roller coaster.
Maybe same like me.
But
I'm so
we convinced her and she's women.
Okay, thank you, Reshati. When he said people are contributing points, people are adding up, right? That makes more interactive. Thank you. Okay, Vaishnavi, are you ready now?
Mommy,
can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Okay, ma'am.
Trivali finish, Anish finish, then I'm not getting your name, Nisha Ferrari. What's your name, Ferrari?
Can I start? Ferrari.
Yeah.
Can I start? Human memory is a fabulous thing. Memories are lifetime experience. Namaste. Today, I, Vaishnavi, will be telling you one of my unforgettable moments. I have lots of unforgettable moments, and it is very difficult to choose one of them. But I have chosen one of them, and it was my first international flight to Bangkok. It was a marvelous flight, and I went with my family when I was in first grade. The malls were wow, and the Then we went to a zoo. That was a kind. There we saw dolphin shows and then a lot of things. But one of my favorites was the seal show. Then we went to the safari park. That was very great. All filled with animals and all, so I liked it. And then we went to the Golden Buddha temple. It was so big and my eyes didn't stop seeing it. I liked it a lot. And that was my first international trip, as I said. And I liked it a lot. And the trip was awesome. Thank you.
Great. Nice experience, young guys. Okay. Who's next?
Mommy.
So we go. Yes, sorry. I'm enjoying
Imagine
the story.
What will be your situation when you get lost in an unknown place? Good morning to one and all. I am Pradeep and would like to share an unforgettable moment of mine. I remember when I was 4 years old, me and my family went to a hilltop Genting in Malaysia. Then we visited the big mall there. After finishing the shopping, we came out to get into our car. There was fog outside as it was December month. And for our surprise, we couldn't find our car. We were lost. I was scared. We searched a lot. After 1 hour of continuous searching, we finally found our car. I was just 4 years old then, but still, I could remember my panicking incident till today. Apart from that, I even had a memorable incident that was unforgettable, and that is my grand birthday celebrations in Malaysia. Thank you.
Great. Who's next? Sharanya, late today, huh? Late today, why? Okay, who's next? Yasika, Bhumika, Krita, Suhana, Vani. Krita, okay. Yashika, Bhumika, Suhana, Vani are still pending. Yes, Krita?
My most memorable moment was when my brother was born. It was last year when I was eating with my friend in her house. My father called from the hospital and he told me that I had a newborn brother. So then I was so happy. Me and my grandmother rushed to the hospital and I felt so excited and happy. My father took me to the NICU room. After I was standing outside the room and I tried to measure my brother's feet with my finger. But he was too fast, so I couldn't see his face properly. So my father showed me one of his photos that day.
Okay, I think it's related to Ananya. Ananya had a sister, you had a brother.
Yeah.
Okay, that's such a lovely, yeah. Touching people are. Okay, next. Who's next? Suhana, Vani, Yashika. Tell me, Yashika.
Should I?
I think Yashika's on mute now. I mean, yeah. Go ahead, Yashika. After that, you can go, Vani. Yashika.
Vani.
No, I think. Yashika, you want to speak? Unmute. Okay, Vani, go ahead. I think she's put on mute.
Yes, yes ma'am. So, this might not be the same for all, but for me, the most unforgettable moment is when I met few people in my life, and they're none other than my classmates.
Okay.
Last year, I had a great year, and I hope I have a good year next year ahead too. So, these people were everything to me. First, I didn't know who they are, and now they are my best friend. The whole year, I was with them. And I always felt their support always throughout. They always supported me in any situation, whether I was right or wrong, whether I was sad or happy. The whole year, I just had fun with them. No matter how many fights we had, we were always one. It is said that friendship is the purest love. We should never lose a friend of ours, because we don't need a mirror if you find a real friend. A quote which I really like is, an idiot who makes you laugh in his presence will definitely make you cry in their absence, because they are your real friends. Thank you.
Wow, that's lovely. Well said quote. By the way, who gave the quote?
These types of friends are very rare.
Very rare. Nowadays,
I don't have any friends.
To be honest, I have no friends. I don't get time to spend time.
Mom, people bully me instead of making friends.
Yeah, be careful. We need to be aware of them. Okay, who's next? Vani, it's very lovely, heart-touching.
Ma'am.
Ananya and Krita had a very similar stories. Yes, Yashuka. Tell me, Yashuka.
Good morning, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Yashuka. I'm studying in 9th standard in St. Mary's Girls High School. So, I'm very glad to get an opportunity to share my personal views about the topic given the unforgettable experience. So, one of my most unforgettable experiences, the most important and beautiful experience in my life days of the leadership in my class. It was the very first time, and it was a new class for me, and my new teacher selected me as a class rep. Very beautiful, because my classmates obeyed me and kept silence in the class, and the surprise was the next leaders were not able to control the class as me. Teachers appreciated me for everything I have done. I don't know whether it's because I'm a stranger or something else, but I love my leadership experience and my class. So thank you.
Okay, thank you. That's very nice. A classroom. Did you all experience like this? You know what? To be a leader in the class, something great.
Mom, every year I get it.
But difficult, with, right?
Different. My classmates.
Sometimes you have to show enmity.
Mom, in our class, not even one person listens to us. They make full noise.
You should learn public speaking.
Yes, ma'am.
You should get connected to the people. Sharanya, Suhani, who else? Vinodini, she's on the cameras off. Suhana. Who else? Are we going to wind up? Because I have another sector to finish. Sharanya, are you there? Can you listen to some unforgettable experience? Do you have something to share with us? Which you can't forget in your life. Swana is always on in. What happened? Swana, what's happening with you? You're just getting out and coming in. Yeah. Shani, is there anything else to go? Okay, fine. So let me wind up today. Let me finish talk. Okay? I don't want to take more of your time because I said 12 people are logging in. I get lots of activities. Well, I would like to know, when you start closing your topic, right? You all give a beautiful incident of the closure, right? About your past experience. Fun-loving, especially, what's his name? Nisha Rajesh, I'm getting his name there. He or she, I don't know. Manasa. Are you he or she? She. Manasa. You can type in the chat. I'm so sorry. Ferrari, right? Pratip joined with you because he's the same city, you know? He joined with you and added a point there. That's the kind of interactive what you had. People love to hear. Leadership qualities, when she said, Pradeep again said, ma'am, I also have it. Vaishali also said, ma'am, but nobody listens to me. Very good when you start sharing your views and all this. So when you say public speaking, it's so open to share your opinion. Did you love this?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? You always, whenever you start speaking, start sharing your own stories. See ya. When you are trying to finish your conversation, people should know you're going to end. Now, most of the stories, I could not see the end. I'm just listening. What? I'm still waiting. Okay, still there or finished? There should be some kind of a conclusion. For example, let me take Vani and Yashika. Vani said that she gave the beautiful closure call, this thing happened. right? And she ended up with a beautiful closure. Yashika said that the leadership, I just love it. And Pradeep, he gave a closure by ending up saying that I could not forget my birthday celebration, the grand finale celebration, I think, Pradeep had over there. Vaishnavi, each one had a beautiful closure. When you end a closure, make a note, when you think I'm going to end the presentation, just don't say thank you, thanks for patient hearing, no. You can do a very simple step. The first one, you should, the audience should know that you're going to finish. As I'm going to do it now for you all. I'm going to do it now for you. You should give a signal that she's going to finish the presentation. For example, when you say that, guys, I think everything is clear. This is how we go with it. Give some points. You give some signal, okay, I'm going to finish. Rather saying thank you. Don't say that. Okay, sometimes you can also come with all your points. For example, let's see, for example now. Let me take my example. Guys, I hope you all enjoyed the show today. I'll just wind up before I wind up, I'd just like to give four sessions, step of public speaking. One is the main content element of public speaking is presentation, content, and closure. So here, the presentation, we're talking about the steps. When you're speaking, a public speaking, you need to follow the four basic steps which you can apply it everywhere. The first one is before we speak, how to start a presentation, effective content delivery, and how to end the presentation. I believe you all understood this point, right? I have only one last point to finish it up. Let me share that to you all. Can you see my screen? I'm bad in sharing.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Really? Let me see what are you able to share. Let me see what are you able to see my screen. I hope it's on the wrong screen. Okay. The step to close the presentation, the step to close anything here. First, show them you're going to conclude, you're going to sum up, or in summary, I've said now, guys, before winding up, I just want to finish up by saying that we have four steps to do effective communication. One is before you speak, how to start, effective content delivery, and the closure. So it means that I'm going to conclude. So people are aware that, okay, ma'am is going to conclude. Next, tell them what you learned in this. In this presentation, you learned about how to present yourself effectively, about your body language, about your vocal variety. Then, the last, ask them whether they have any questions. Give them a chance to interact with them. And if it's something like a motivation, say them, give them advices, like Vani said now. It's a piece of advice, a beautiful quote. It's a nice message. And advise them, okay, fine, you're done with this, go for the next step. And use a clinch. When whoever's starting in the beginning, the same quote can be used in the end. And then you can say bye, see you all. It's a lovely time to sign you. Right?
Mom, can you share your unforgettable moment?
My unforgettable moment, I'll share it in my... Yeah, thank you so much. That's wonderful. I love to share my moment. I have many unforgettable moments. But I'll share one unforgettable moment pertaining to this class, relevant to this class. I joined my career as a teaching profile in 2009, Jan 9th. In 2009. I'm a very good speaker like you. I really appreciate you all. You're tremendous. I had been, before that I was working in IT sector, in a HR field. And they called me I left the job 2008. There was a recession, so I dropped it. In 2009, I was just looking for a job. I didn't get a proper in IT sector back. And I was looking for this job here. Wherein, they called me for a faculty. I didn't know what is the meaning of faculty. I know what is the meaning of teacher. What's the meaning of professor. I didn't know. But I know what a faculty is. And when I went for interview, they rejected me saying that I didn't know Kannada. I'm from Bangalore. I didn't know Kannada. I know Hindi. I know Tamil. I know a bit of Telugu. Bit of Kannada I know. But the problem is, I didn't know how to teach them. They rejected.
Ma'am, what was your mother tongue? Ma'am, what is your mother tongue?
Tamil.
Tamil?
Yeah, but
my mother tongue is Kannada.
Ayyo, Anik, I know Kannada. Now I know Kannada. In ninth, they called me. They rejected me. On 8th, I don't know, okay, 8th Jan. I just said, it's okay, no problem. I'll try another job. Jan 9th, they called me. Can you come at 7 o'clock, 6:45 to the institute? I said, 6 to why? Anyway, they rejected me, right? Keeping that in mind, I just had a casual talk. They said, excuse me, you have a batch now at 7 o'clock evening. They called me at 6:45. And they're telling me at 7 o'clock you have a batch. I said, what kind of batch is it? No, you have to teach them spoken English. You know what? I thought, spoken English. Everyone speaks English. Why English here? Because the same category. Then I said, no, please go to that room. Room number one. Your batch are there, 7 o'clock. And I just opened the door. I could see all elderly persons. All college-going guys. All ladies and men. I was thinking, how stupid. Don't they know English? They're coming for English class. I work in Vita. That was my opinion. Trust me, I was sweating so badly seeing the huge crowd. There were 25 in the batch. 25. I have not done any teaching profile. I just do training, come back. I was thinking, what to do? I was sweating so badly. Can't. I just said, excuse me, please visit. I'm just going out. I went out. I told my receptionist, sorry, I can't take this class. She said, why? No, I don't have any teaching experience. What do you say? She said, I'm so sorry, you can't say anything now. You're appointed, you have to take class. Jan 9th, that is how I started my class. I was sweating so badly. I was comfortable after they talking to me. You know why? Because they don't know how to introduce yourself. They don't know to make sentences. They didn't know how to behave themselves in the class. Like, I was wondering, wow, what a nice people I got. That was a weakness. Their weakness was strength for me. And they asked one question, ma'am, do you know Kannada? Oh my God, terrible. I said, I can manage. Then they said, ma'am, can you explain in local language? I said, which language? Can you speak in Hindi? Done. Then that is how my career started. Trust me, one hour, I was sweating. I was sweating so badly because I don't know how to manage the team. I don't know what to speak. Then 1 hour, I asked, they said, I am this. I was just enjoying. I sat in my chair and sat because I know I can do this. I can know the weakness. That is how I took the attention of the audience. I spoke to them in Hindi, then I spoke to them in Kannada, then I spoke to them in Tamil, I spoke to them a bit of Telugu. Then don't ask me, Vaishnavi, ma'am, you know Telugu. I know a bit, okay, but I can't tell you. This is how we learned up. And that is how my career started. In 2009, the very first year, still I could not forget. I thank whoever gave me a wonderful opportunity. I got the very next year, second batch. Third day, I got 2 batches more. I developed the skill of talking. I did hard work. Seriously, I did lots of hard work. I went to Google, did the translation work. I did lots of hard work. Did the preparation. If tomorrow is my class, I do lots of preparation. Write each batch when I should do it. And today, I have my own institute, The Art of Communicating. Since 2015, I've been doing it formally, 2017. This is my unforgettable experience for this episode. Because you're
mom, very good.
How's it?
Mom, amazing.
Very good, ma'am. Very good.
Ma'am, it is very inspiring.
Very inspiring.
Yeah, you should do that. Very I'm telling you, inspiring. If you want to inspire, yeah, if you want to do something, do crazy work. Do crazy work. My mom keeps asking, what do you do in the office at 2 o'clock in the office? See, I keep talking to people. This is my audience. I keep like this. Okay, hello, everybody. How are you? I can talk to them. This is how you need to practice. Keep some 2 dolls and look at them and practice. And guys, okay, if you want to go for more of this conversation, I think we still have the classes. I just want a brief idea about the workshop. Because we are they are so in depth. There are 10 more. I mean, this class. Okay. Any class?
Bye.
Let the class, everybody. Yeah. See you then. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye. Good day.
Bye.
Be safe.